guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm back with another get ready with me. So today's wig is from Rpgshow wigs, and I'm working with this brown wig with some blonde highlights at the top, as you guys can see. I'm so in love with this wig right now, guys. I'm not gonna lie to you, I'm so in love with this wig. So the length of the wig is 20, so this is a 20 inch wig, and the density is 200%. And also, when it comes to me installing this wig, I literally did not apply anything to this wig. This wig is absolutely glueless and it fits perfectly on my head. I'm just so happy with this wig. I'm happy with the lace because it literally melts in without me even having to do anything. And when it comes to my makeup today, I'm going to be trying out some new makeup products that I got through PR. So if you guys want to see how I got this whole look together and my wig, then make sure you stay tuned and carry on watching. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and install this wig. You guys can see I've already gone ahead to style the wig and it's looking real good. It looks really flat, and I did tone the hair as well just because I felt like it had some brassy undertone that I wasn't really feelings. So I'm going to insert a picture showing you guys what purple shampoo I used. So all I'm going to do now is just to install the wig. I want to see if I can try and get a glueless install, because that would be amazing. I don't want to have to glue this wig down. Okay, so I've cut off all the excess lace, but you guys can still see that, you know, the lace doesn't exactly match my skin tone. So if I was to glue it down and use my bedhead spray or any hairspray, this would actually melt into my skin. But because I don't want to glue it down, I'm going to go ahead and just apply the foundation that I've got on my brush. So I'm not going to apply any more products. I'm just going to use what I've got left on the brush and literally just run this through the lace. So you guys can see how it's literally just melting into my skin. It looks so good, and I've not even glued it down. Like, this is not glued down. So the wig obviously comes with an elastic band and also comes with adjustable straps at the back. So I've basically used the adjustable straps and also the elastic band that the wig comes with, and it fits really secure on my head. Like, it doesn't feel like, you know, it's gonna move or anything like that. So like I said, this wig is from Rpgshow wigs. I'm so happy with how quick it was to install this wig. Like, it literally took me like 5 minutes, no lie. So you can see the wig is not glued down, especially around the sides, but that's okay because I'm gonna wear my hair down as a middle part anyway, so you're not really gonna see, you know, the sides. But I'm fine with this because I really don't want to use any glue on my hair today, so this is okay. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna use brown hair dye. So this is something I've been seeing like hairstylists do on YouTube. So I'm gonna grab my comb and I'm just gonna place this in the center. Yes, I'm gonna grab this L'Oreal dark brown magic retouch spray. So this is what it looks like. So this is the dark brown. As you can see, I got two of them. I got the black and I got the dark brown. So this is the black and that's the dark brown. So the black would make sense when I have a jet black wig or something, but because, you know, the roots are brown, I'm gonna use the dark brown once a day. But yeah, let me just try and get this in a straight line first. I hope that's straight. And now I'm just gonna go ahead and just spray. Okay, so I think I'm gonna use the black instead. I don't think the dark brown, I don't think that one's dark enough because you guys can see it. So what I'm gonna do this time is I'm gonna grab a hairband, any hairband like this. And what I did was I basically cut this down the middle. So now I have a strand of elastic band, and I basically put my T-pin through the elastic band because I have no one to hold this for me. I'm gonna make sure I don't poke myself, obviously, but I'm gonna put this down the middle and just hook it onto my hair like so. That's okay. It doesn't have to go all the way in. And then now I'm gonna go ahead and try spraying this again, and let's see. I think we got it. Yes, the line is like straight down the middle, which I'm very happy about. So just to make that stand out a bit more, I'm just gonna go ahead and apply some powder. Even Okay, so moving on to makeup, I'm going to be trying out some products from KVD and ABH. I've actually tried out the new concealers from ABH before, but the shades I had were not bright enough for me. So now I've got some lighter shades, and you guys know I like my bright under eyes. So I'll definitely be using these today. And then for foundation, I don't know if I should use the Look It foundation from KVD or if I should use the Good Apple foundation. I've heard so much about this foundation. This foundation was trending on TikTok based on, you know, the coverage and everything. But apparently if you have oily skin, you should stay away from this foundation. So I'm kind of like, I'm in two minds. I don't know if I should use this or if I should. I've used this foundation before and I really like it, but the shade I had was too dark for me. So I'm going to start off by priming my face using the e.l.f. Poreless Primer. So I really like this primer because I feel like it really helps to, it does blur out your pores and, you know, just gives you like a smooth base to work on. So I think I'm going to use the Look It foundation today in the shade Deep Neutral. So this is Deep 78 Neutral. Too light for me, definitely too light for me. So I'm gonna try the Deep Warm as well. So this is shade 79. It's just a shade up from this one. Guys, when I tell you the coverage from this foundation is mad. Like, I feel like just KVD products in general, they're all very much full coverage. Like their makeup products is the type of makeup that can basically cover up tattoos and stuff, so you can imagine how good the coverage must be, like literally. And now I'm gonna go ahead and use my beauty blender and just you know, press that into my skin a bit more. I'm gonna go ahead and apply some concealer. I'm gonna use the KVD Look It concealer in the shade D31. It has a warm undertone. Also, when it comes to their concealer, the coverage, listen, coverage is absolutely insane. Honestly, just go for KVD because their products are very much full coverage. This is definitely for a girl that likes that full glam, you know, like, yes, this is it. Coverage is everything. So I'm just going to apply one more layer of concealer, but I'm going to use the ABH concealers instead. Let me know if my lighting is good because I feel like with this new setup, sometimes you can't see the true color of what I'm applying, like the shades and everything. I don't know. Maybe I should turn off my ring light. I think this is better. So as I was saying, I feel like the coverage from the ABH concealer is just insane. I've only applied a small amount and guys, this is... Okay, so moving on to contour, I actually forgot that I have some cream contour products from KVD as well. So I'm going to use the KVD Liquid Gel Contour and I have two shades. I have medium tan and I have tan neutral. So this is the shade tan neutral. Medium tan is really nice. I like both of them. So I've never tried using the blush that comes in this palette. This is the palette from Morphe. I'm gonna use this one right here. Okay, so moving on to my lips, I'm going to use the new ABH lip liner. This is in the shade Malt. And I think this is the darkest brown lip pencil that they have. So let's see how this looks. They have another one called Chai, but I feel like Chai is more on the... kind of has a red undertone. So this is Chai. You can see Chai has a red undertone. And this is Malt that I'm going to apply now. I'm going to use Malt to line my lips. And then for lipstick, I'm going to apply the ABH Satin Lipstick in the shade Butterscotch. And this is what it looks like. You guys let me know which one you prefer, no ring light or ring light, because I feel like without the ring light, you guys can actually see my true skin tone. Whereas with the ring light, I look quite washed out. So let me know. I don't know. Yeah, let me know what you guys think. Now I'm just going to go ahead and run my straighteners through the hair real quick. I really love this wig. I love the hair color. I love everything. I love the highlights. So gorgeous. This is amazing. Okay, so this is the finished look, and like I said, this wig is from Rpgshow wigs, and the length of the wig is 20. I'm gonna get up in a second so you guys can see where it's up to. So this is where the wig is up to on me. But when it comes to the density of the wig, the density is 200, which I wouldn't say this wig feels like a 200 density. It feels more like 180, but I feel like regardless, I just love everything about this wig. I would definitely recommend you get the 200% density if you want this exact look, because I'm not sure if any other density will give you this exact look that I have right here. So I don't know the name of the wig, but I'll make sure to list all the information and details that you guys need to know about this wig down below in the description box. Everything I've used, I'll list it all down below. And when it comes to my makeup, guys, listen, like I said, if you are not a full coverage babe, then the products I've used today, stay away from them. But if you like that full glam, full beat, full makeup face, full coverage, everything, KVD, listen, KVD is the brand for you. KVD and ABH concealer, the coverage is everything. Honestly, it's everything. So yeah, you guys let me know what you think of this look in the comment section. And also guys, remember, like I said, this wig is 100% glueless. I haven't glued it down, but I've literally not applied anything to this lace. Like literally the only thing I did was apply my foundation brush over the lace. So yeah, please don't forget to leave a comment down below. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not subscribed, okay? And I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.